Konnichiwa YouTubers, this is Wrist Talk straight from Japan, and today we're going to do a video review of SH Figure Arts Kadoshiba Shinken Red. Now this differs from the other Shinken Red because this is her brother, I think. I don't follow this line, Shinkenger. I don't follow it. Sorry. That's alright. Well, let me show you the box. Nice little figure, I'm gonna say. She's a female. Kadu, that's her name. Shinken Red. You can actually see that over here. Kadoshiba, that's really her name. SH Figure Arts Bandai. Yes, forget the Shinkenger line. It does have quite a bit of accessories, and I'll show you these in a little bit. Her skirt also comes apart, but I really don't like these little three-piece things, and I'll show you here in a little bit. So that's pretty much the box, nothing special. But let's go look at the figure. A little, you know, this is a great little figure. I like the Shinkenger line. The attention to detail is good. Not as glossy as the gold one that I reviewed earlier, but the detail is really good. Let me take off this sword over here. And if you would like, you can put the sword here on its hilt. Oops, put it backwards. There we go. Just slide that in. There we go. And it holds rather fine. Great little details on the red, the little notch marks on the mask. Ball jointed head, the neck does crane a little bit, so it does have pretty good amount of details. It's red, it's black, I mean, come on, it's not that bad. It's pretty basic, but what can you say? But the amount of articulation is just the same. Little badge on her gi or whatever the heck that is. So ball jointed elbow, sorry, not ball jointed shoulder, couldn't say that. And it does shrug a little bit, so you can definitely, like, if you wanted to pull it in, definitely can. Double jointed elbow, as you can see, ball jointed wrist, and the wrists are interchangeable, and I'll show you all these extra parts over here. The leg is on a ball joint and can move up and down. You can actually, without me, well, we won't need that, so I'm, yeah, oh, it's popped it off, which is a pain. There we go, snaps right back in. What do you call that? You have a waist swivel, ab crunch, and yeah, I'm brain farting all over the place. Double jointed knee, look at the articulation on that. And foot is on a ball joint and can definitely pivot quite a bit. And you have that little toe swivel. So very good articulation. Has a little shadow phone here on the side, isn't removable. But in addition to those, let me show you the other pieces that you can get. Hopefully I won't follow that. The Rekka Daisanto. Look at the size of this thing. She can't hold it without some kind of stand. These are the little skirt pieces that you can have. They come in three little pieces and you can remove them. But I really don't like that. I like the skirt pieces in one piece. You got different fists, of course. Open fist. Fist to hold the phone here. Closed fist. Open palms. Blade for karate. So I forget, that's 10 extra pieces, no, 8 extra pieces, so not too bad. Oh yeah, and I forgot the little shadow phone. If you want to put it, you can put it in one of her fists. Man, I'm all sorts of jacked up today, can't think. That's all right so very good articulation. I really like that. The attention to detail is pretty good, but it's kind of basic for a figure, but hey, what can I say? And again, this humongous sword, the Rekka Daisanto, I think that's what it's called. There we go. Detail on that. Beautiful, huge sword. You can definitely have her hold it. This little piece over here does spin around. So she can hold it, but that's about all she's going to be able to do because this thing is huge. Not exactly meant for posing. Maybe I can get her to pose, but hey, there we go. She can definitely hold it. But this thing is, look at, it's already leaning, as you can see. So she ain't gonna be able to hold that humongous sword without a stand or something like that. So she's gonna fall down. Oh well. So let's give her a nice little size comparison. She's just as good as Shinken Gold if the color isn't that great, or as shiny or bright or anything. But, oh, one thing I forgot to mention is a skirt piece. If you wanna remove it, all you have to do is just pop the top off right here. Move the little belt over here. And the skirt pieces are contained over here, so if you wanted to remove that and give her the skirt piece, you certainly can. So, but the skirt piece is made of a nice soft plastic, and it really doesn't hinder the piece that much. Besides, I like the more feminine features. So let's go ahead, set her down. There we go. Yeah, that's the only thing I don't like is that, hey, she has small feet as per, hey, they are female. There we go, she's standing upright. And she can't all be clown feet like. Whoops, I bumped that. Al can't be clown-footed like good old Megatron right here. She's slightly smaller. She's about 5 1/4 inches smaller than Shinkin Gold. And I can't find the boy, so hey, stop bugging me. Oh, I forgot. Shinkin Maru. That's a little, the other small sword. All right, beautiful. I'll still give her 8.5 out of 10 because, hey, it works really good. Really nice looking. I wish the paint apps were a little glossier, but other than that, not bad after all. All right, YouTubers, that's all I got. And I'll catch you all next time.